So dear students, today I am going to explain the T-traversal scheme for the binary search tree as well as general tree. It may be any tree, and we will apply the traversal. As we know, the traversal is the visiting each element one by one. So normally in tree, traversing can be categorized in four categories. First is level order traversal, second is in order traversal, third is pre-order traversal, and fourth one is post-order traversal. So we will explain one by one. This is the first traversal scheme. This is known as in-order traversal scheme. Here we are taking an example. In this example, the root node is 10. At the left hand side, some other nodes are there, and the right hand side also. So when we apply in order traversal, so as we know, in order traversal scheme, first we traversal the left subtree and then the root, then we process the root node. After that we process the right subtree. So the order in the in order traversal is left subtree, then the root node, and then the right subtree. So first we will visit the left subtree. In this left subtree, again we will apply the in order scheme. So we'll process first the left subtree of this root node. This is 12, the left of sub this is 3, and then we will process, we will visit 12, and then we will hit the right subtree. After coming on this right subtree, we will again apply the in order. So we will visit 6 first, and then we will visit 4, then we will visit therefore the sequence will be, first we will visit 3 and then the root node, then we will visit 12. After this, when we will come in this right subtree of this, then we will visit 6, and then we will visit 4, and after that we will visit 7. So now this is the completion of this left subtree. This is the completion of this left subtree. After that we will visit the root node, and then we will come to the right subtree. Now we will apply the in order traversal scheme on this right subtree. So when we will come in this right subtree, then we will process the left element. This is 11, and after that we will visit 5, and then we will visit 2, and then there is no element at the left hand side, that's why we will visit 2, and then we will visit 8. That's why the sequence in order traversal scheme will be, this is 3 12 6 4, and then this is the root node, this is 10, and then 11, then 5, then 2, then 8. Now we will come to the pre-order traversal scheme. Again we are taking the same example. So in pre-order, first we process the root, and then process the left subtree. After this we process the right subtree. So first we will visit 10, this is root node, this will be 10, and after this on this left subtree we will apply the pre-order traversal scheme. So in this scheme, the next element will be 12, we will visit 12, after the, because we will apply the pre-order on this entire subtree. So the first, this will be 12, after this we will process the 3 left subtree, and then we will process the right subtree. On this right subtree again we will apply the pre-order scheme. That's why the next element will be 4, after that this will be 6, and then the next element will be 7. So first we visit this root node, after that we visited this left subtree. After this we will come to the right subtree, and we will apply the same pre-order traversal scheme to this right subtree. So when we will apply on this, then the first element will be 5, and the second element we will visit, this will be 11, because we are again applying the pre-order scheme on this. So this will be 11, after that this will be 2, and then there is no element at the left hand side, there this will be 8. So the pre-order traversal will be 10, 10, then 12, then 3, then 4, then 6, then 7, and then 5 and 11, then 2 and then 8. Now this is the post order traversal. In the post order traversal, we first process the left subtree and then right subtree and then root node. So when we will process this, we will apply the post order again. We'll apply the post order on this entire left subtree. So first element will be, we will visit first 3, and then we will visit this right part. This will be 4, 6, 7. So we will visit 6 and then 7. This is 7 and then 4. Now this is complete and this is complete. So we will visit, after this we will visit the root. So this will be 12. Now this is complete and the order is 3, then 6, then 7, then 4, then 6, 7, then 4 and then 12. Now this left part is complete. Now we will apply the post order traversal scheme on the right subtree. So right subtree, this is right subtree. Now we are applying the post order on this. The left element is this 11. This will be 11. After that we will process this. So the next element should be the left child of this, but this is absent, that's why we will process the 8 and then 2. Now this is complete, so the next element will be 5, and now this right part is complete. So last will be the root node, because we have processed the left subtree, then the right subtree, and then the finally the this is the root node. So this is the post order traversal, and this will be the 3, 6, 7, then 4, 12, 11, 8, 2, 5, and 10. This is the last scheme of traversing. This is the label order traversal scheme. In this, we do nothing but we go label by label. We visit the element label by label. This is the first label. 10 is on the first label. 12 and 5 on the second label. 3, 4, 11, 2, these are on the third label. 6, 7, 8, they are the on the next label. So first we will visit 10 and then we will visit elements of the next table. This is 12 and then we will visit 12. After that we will visit the next elements on the next label, 3, then 4, then 11 and 2, and after this 6, 7, 8. So the order will be, first we will visit 10, this is the root node, then we will visit the element of second label, this is 12 and 5, and then after this we will visit 3, 4, 11 and 12, 2 sorry, and then we will visit 6, 7 and 8. So this is the label order traversal scheme. So this is all about the traversing on the tree. Thank you.